Well, we go to Celebrity Meltdowns, Late Night Edition.
It's really hard.
After Donald Trump regained the presidency by soundly trouncing Willie Brown's side piece,
know your damn role and shut your damn mouth.
Late Night host Jimmy Kimmel and Stephen Colbert both lost their shit. I'm Jazz Borgonzo on this. And guess who got the blame?
Don't say it, don't say it.
The voters.
Yes, of course.
Ah, when the left did their own.
Fuck!
It's a good thing. And it's what's next. What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Jazz Borgonzo, what's next? Your daily dose. Hope you guys are feeling good today. Of course, it is Friday, TGIF. It's always a nice thing when you go into the weekend. Well, we are 72 hours removed from the greatest comeback in political history, presidential history. One, Donald J. Trump regains the presidency. He's now Agent 47. But we've seen some meltdowns. We've seen some media meltdowns. We've seen some celebrity meltdowns. We've seen even knuckleheads on TikTok and their epic meltdowns. Mwah. Masterpiece theater. But what about the late night hosts? You know, they've been relatively quiet, you know, up until last night, where both Jimmy Kimmel and Stephen Colbert both lost their shit. And guess who got the blame? Oh, yes, the voters. It's your fault. Ah, when the left eat their own, it's always, always a good thing. This comes out of Breitbart. Late night meltdown. Kimmel tears up. Colbert lectures America for rejecting Camila. Aw, what a shame. Late night comedians Jimmy Kimmel and Stephen Colbert experienced emotional meltdowns Wednesday in their first broadcast after President-elect Donald Trump soundly whooped the ass of Willie Brown's side piece. In the presidential election, Kimmel held back tears and was clearly a difficult show for the comedian, who has devoted much airtime in recent years to bashing Trump and his supporters. ABC's Jimmy Kimmel was on the visibly verge of crying during parts of his opening monologue. Let's hear a bit, shall we?
Let's be honest, it was a terrible night last night. It was a terrible night for women, for children, for the hundreds of thousands of hardworking immigrants who make this country go, for healthcare, for our climate, for science, for journalism, for justice, for free speech. It was a terrible night for poor people, for the middle class, for seniors who rely on Social Security, for our allies in Ukraine. For NATO.
Ukraine. Climate change. Yes. I feel you. I feel you, Jimmy. I feel you. He continued. It was a terrible night for poor people, middle class, seniors who rely on Social Security, our allies in Ukraine, NATO, truth and democracy and decency. Kimmel managed to pull himself together long enough to hurl insults at Trump. Of course he did. And at one point comparing the president-elect to an emperor in Star Wars movies. Meanwhile, Stephen Colbert took an angry approach to the election outcome. Well, it happened. Well, I don't want to read it. Let's hear it.
I'm your host, Stephen Colbert. Well, it happened again. After a bizarre and vicious campaign fueled by a desperate need not to go to jail, Donald Trump has won the 2024 election.
Desperate need. You sure about that, Stephen? You sure? Okay.
It's almost like you rehearsed that.
No.
The deep shock and sense of loss is enormous. Okay, but let's look at the bright side. This way, at least, there'll be a peaceful transfer of power. Mike Pence, Ali Ali oxen free. All day yesterday, I was walking around proudly wearing my I voted sticker. Today, I wore my I am questioning my fundamental belief in the goodness of humanity sticker. Now, they give those out.
Yes, because goodness and humanity doesn't, you know, mean not voting for Trump. Of course
it does. As a late night host, people often say to me, come on, part of you has got to want Trump to win because he gives you so much material to work with. No.
No one bullshit.
Tells the guy who cleans the bathroom, wow, you must love it when someone has explosive diarrhea. There's so much material for you to work with.
Wow, that's, now, Nice. Comparing Trump to Tutsis.
Is that good?
Beautiful.
I wish you Brilliant. Wish so many of us wish this hadn't happened, but that is not for us to decide. This is a democracy. That's democracy with a capital duh. And in this democracy, the majority has spoken, and they said they don't care that much about democracy. And I want.
No, we care about the rule of law. We care about, respect and honor after you guys have trashed us, censored us, told us to go for ourselves. Well, guess what? Fuck you.
I want to take a moment to congratulate Kamala Harris and Tim Walz on running an amazing 107-day campaign.
Yeah, an amazing campaign. You know, hundreds of millions of dollars are spent. Now they're $20 million in the hole. You know, all for, you know, a woman who spends a lot of time on her knees. And, of course, a guy who likes to use tampons. Okay.
That was extraordinary. Right out of the gate. They hit it right out of the gate. Firstly, I hope they stay in touch. I know they're really good at texting.
Pathetic. NBC's Seth Meyers, yes, the redheaded stepchild, took more of an emo approach in resurrecting Kamala Harris's joy. He opened his monologue saying, "It was a privilege to be here with you, not to feel alone," adding, "We're not going to let anyone take that joy away, even when we're talking about things that are not particularly joyful." Well. I love it. I absolutely love it when the left, you know, rip holes in each other. I love it. Funny how Kimmel cried, shocker, and Colbert blamed the voters. Well, they kind of both blamed the voters. Yeah, you got lectured. It's your fault, voters. You guys didn't do enough. It's your fault, voters. You guys didn't, you know, push hard enough. You know, you kicked the old man out, you cooed the old man, and then you spent hundreds of millions of dollars. Now you're in debt, and all for a woman who has zero policy. She had zero policy, and every time she opened her mouth, it was word salad galore. But she was better than Donald Trump, who already had presidential experience, and who knows how to read the room. This is going to be so good for the next 4 years. So good. Because, of course, you know, Colbert's calling bullshit that he's not going to be, you know, tearing holes into Trump for the next 4 years, which is absolutely bullshit, because that's what they do. He and Kimmel both. And Seth Meyers to a degree. And let's not forget Jimmy Fallon. Wow, talk about the fourth man, you know, left off. Where the hell is he? Anyway, at the end of the day, more meltdowns. I'm loving it. You're loving it. And with that being said, I'm Jazz Bergonzo. This is What's Next. Want to see more like this? Please leave a comment below. Like it, share, subscribe to it. Hit that subscription. And with that being said, I'm Jazz Bergonzo. This is What's Next. Want to see more like this? Please leave a comment below. Like it, share it, subscribe to it. Hit that notification bell so you guys never miss a thing. Appreciate you guys watching as always. And we'll see you on the next one. Peace.